I don't think we've really had a strong president since Ronald Reagan. But I'm going to say this about Ronald Reagan, I feel the same way about Trump. Ronald Reagan was not a genius, but he surrounded himself with great people. I bought this place in 1983.
I'm a conservative. As a businessman, I have to be a conservative.
So what kind of people come into this bar?
People from every walk of life in Western New York. Back then it was primarily blue collar.
You sit here in the corner every day and you hear what everyone's talking about. What are they saying about the election?
When it comes to politics, the discussion ultimately gets about around Donald Trump, and across the board, people are saying, he's got it right, I'm voting for him. And that's what scares them, because he's not a political guy.
Can you tell us about this area?
The area was a big industrial and service and shipping area. And at the time, in the turn of the century, because of the grain mills, and it was the entrance to the Midwest.
Can you tell us about the late 70s and early 80s, when a lot of the, you know, mill plants and factories started to close around here? What was that like?
Over a period of time, it became devastating, particularly to the people that were losing their jobs and depended on this waterfront.
It seems like the last 5 or 6 years, the place has changed a lot.
It's changed dramatically, and for a number of reasons. New apartments are being made downtown, and the city itself now is moving towards making it nice for everyone.
Like, when you think about Buffalo, you think about what the city has gone through and how things are starting to turn around. Which candidate do you see being the best to keep that going?
Trump is the most qualified, bar none.
Why?
Because he's run a multi-billion dollar empire, and he knows how to motivate people. He's going to surround himself with people that are going to be very good. There's factions out there, including the Republican Party, which are insulting the voters that are behind this guy. Let the cards fall where they fall.